SDK, and you see Clemente Suarez in there. You're looking at a new face of comedy. In this season of lockdown where we don't have events, most of these guys who are comedians have found a way to still keep us entertained. They've gone into skits, they've tried different ways of telling stories that would excite us. So today I want to look at the new era of comedy. And SDK is in studio with us. He's a comic actor, a comedian as well. He just had his song with Clemente Suarez. Also in studio with us is Comedian Warris, and a lot of Ghanaians began to pay attention after he returned from Nigeria. He's been with us here, done a lot of skits, come under a lot of criticism. Remember Sarkodie's daughter issue and all of that. Well, I'm going to have a conversation with these two. Welcome, gentlemen.
Actually, it's the new half face.
It's the new half face,
yeah, half face. You can, this is the full face.
The new face,
yeah. Yeah, now I'm new face, half face.
So now it's a new half face of,
yeah,
comedy.
Of comedy.
Anyway, when I said Sarkodie's daughter, you bowed your head. You know, we've moved past that. So why are you still bowing your head to that? Yeah. We've moved past that. Why haven't we?
It's cool.
It's cool, eh? Yeah, that cool. That has been a major mishap you've had, eh?
Yeah, the major one.
But you've learned to stay on guard.
Yeah. Right now it made me a good boy. You understand? Yeah.
But it made you popular as well.
That's the 13th year.
It made me popular.
13th year, eh?
Yeah, that's the 13th year.
Anyway, so you guys have tried your best to keep us entertained during this season. I've seen back-to-back skits from you. I can't even remember. How do you come about these skits? Tell me. Let's start with you.
SDK, because he's doing major.
He's the major, right?
Yeah.
Okay. He says we should start with you.
Okay. The question again.
I knew. Once it's comedy, I knew that we were expecting lots of these.
Okay, so this is how I go about with my skit. I know this year has been a boring year for us. Mm. So coming up with the skit, it's not easy creating, but you know, you have to still.
So, what do you do? You put pen to paper and write?
Yeah, I write every skit I have. I have a script for it.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
What does the inspiration come from? Is it something that has to be trending and then you want to tap into?
For me, I don't follow trends. I don't follow trends because it keeps you in some kind of box. You know, you can't explore your brains and stuff. But what majorly get my ideas from is when I listen to music and walk.
Mm.
When I do that, it just comes naturally. Naturally, my mom and dad are funny, so I think it's in the DNA. It's in my blood and veins. Mm.
Yeah, inbuilt.
Yeah, it's in the saliva too. So I don't struggle with it. Mm. Not that I'm rushing or something, but I don't struggle with coming up with ideas that will make people laugh and, you know, have fun with it. So it's something that is
you just put pen to paper.
Yeah,
you get an inspiration and you put pen to paper. Now, Warris, how do you go about yours as well? Are you also the one who would write, or you just say, oh, I've seen something somewhere and I think that, or I've heard something somewhere and I think I can recreate?
Yeah, I also write. I write very, very, very well.
Oh, I see.
Like, I have almost like 700 folders of script that I want to do, but because of the time,
why is he laughing at you? He doesn't believe you. He says you're lying.
Well, you know, my phone got missing some time ago and then it was brought back. That was the phone I have every folder on. So
the phone was brought back to you?
Yeah.
By the one who stole it?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I think he took it to Circle so that they will unlock it for him. And when he took it there, it was my fan. So my fan was like, no, I know this guy. You stole it.
Really?
Yeah.
Is this a true story? Or
yeah,
one of the,
it's
a
true story.
Because I saw you write that your phone had been stolen.
Yeah, I wrote
stolen.
It. I actually posted it. So that. I think that was what made them bring it back to me.
You must be really popular then.
Yeah.
When your phone gets stolen and you take it to a Circle or wherever,
you
get this return to you.
Yeah,
that's how far comedy has brought you. Now, beyond how far comedy has brought you, you have come under a lot of criticism. People say you are not original. I've seen people say, oh, you look at skits from Sydney in Nigeria and then you remake it and all of that. You're not original.
Whoa. Well, I've out of my almost like 500 skits I've produced so far, I did only one skit which I copied from Sydney the Talker. And that skit, even Sydney copied it from an Indian humorist, you understand? So it's like Ghanaians don't know. Some people don't know that this is how it goes. You take it and then you polish it small. So he polished it and then I took it direct from him. I also polished it, I posted it, and then they were like, yo, you are not original, you are not this. But in that way too, doing skits is a hobby. So when people say I'm not original doing skits, it's not a problem to me because my major thing that I do is stand-up comedy. Mm. Yes, and that is what I think I'm so comfortable with. I've never copied anybody's joke doing stand-up comedy.
Really? Haven't copied anybody's joke? Every joke that Comedian Warris has told, original jokes from
everything. Everything.
And people laugh?
Yeah.
They love it?
Yeah.
I see. I'll come back to why you decided to divert into skits now. But let's talk about you. You two have taken... We've had just this one we had now. And then we had Obolo. You said it was Obolo.
Yeah.
Which is Ololo from Ololo. Stone Boy. Two times I've seen you do works from Stone Boy. I've seen you do some other works as well. Oh, yeah, have you had some backlash for taking, you know, works of people and try to remake it?
No, I've never had such problem. Because I think...
I think you did something for Sark as well.
Yeah, I did Legend. Mm. I did Legend. Mm. I think that's another part of comedy. That's the parody side, which you take original music and make it, I think, recreated in a funny way for people to also enjoy. Mm.
And all these folks have never complained that you
No,
have...
nobody
has. Because I remember that when you did the Obolo, it took a lot of shine off Stone Boy's Ololo because at that time it was also trending and people were giving.
Yeah, I think most of the backlash came from, you know, some other fans that thought like I was making. I think I did the parody for Stone Boy's new album, Anloga Junction. Mm-hmm. I did mine and I did it in Shama Junction. Mm-hmm. So they were like, I think it trended for the day and they were like, oh, I'm trying to take the shine from. I'm like, oh, it's nothing. Even I talked to Stone Boy before doing it and he approved of it. He came to comment, he loved it. I did the video, he posted on his Snapchat and everything. So mostly, sometimes the fans that take things so serious. Yeah.
Mm. I like the fact that you said you speak to the people before you do the work. Even Sarkodie, you had to ask.
Yeah, I had to ask Angel before.
Mm. They gave you.
Yeah, they contacted the producer to give me the beats.
Well, let's see. We've seen something from SDK. Let's see something from Warris. We are back to have some more conversation about, he says we should say the half face.
In our traffics, you know, there are types of, like, people sell, according to, you know, East Legon, they sell with swag in traffic. When you go to East Legon, what do you hear? You hear something like, pure water. Then they will add the swag. Pure. So nice. Or you hear Burkina. Then they add the swag. Burkina. Oh yeah, plantatives. Then the others were plantain. So nice. When you go to Nima and they are selling, you will regret. They sell, they don't even think about you. Pure water. Pure water, mana. Then they will come to your car. Pure water, unti. But you know, they are the most disrespectful people who sell in our traffics. You know, yogurt seller on a normal circumstance, what does he do? He comes to your car and it's like, yogurt! They're like, no. He's like, yogurt! Because the economy is hard, you go around the car and come again, yogurt! But those who don't respect Kosiani Mego sellers, they come and they're like, Osiani! They're like, no. Then they look at you, Osiani!
And that's something from Comedian Warris. Warris, let's stay a little while with you because you've been to Nigeria to perform. When you came back, it was a big deal. I think you went with who was that? I've forgotten. Your two who went at that time?
Myself and Chemical.
Yourself and Chemical. And it was a big deal when you returned.
Yeah.
Having tested what it looks like to do comedy out there and see the kind of backlash sometimes you get when you do comedy in your own country, do you think that we haven't still gotten the idea of what comedy is supposed to be?
I think, in Ghana, we are pushing too hard.
Mm.
We are pushing too hard in Ghana. Because when I went to Nigeria, there were some jokes that I say over here that people don't actually give me the reaction I need. When I went to Nigeria, it was great.
Mm.
You understand? And then they actually came to me. People were backstage telling me, wow, I like how you performed. And your guys, your accent, you can take it to anywhere you want in the world, but ours is called Pidgin. We can't go just anywhere. And I also made them understand that we love their accent when we are in Ghana. So I felt like I wanted to do more in Nigeria more than Ghana because I felt like there are people who are ready to listen and then listen more and push.
What could be our problem here?
Well, our problem is that we have not come to embrace stand-up comedy as it is, but we know the slapstick comedy more than everything, and we understand it so much. Yeah, and particularly for Ghana, sometimes we love our people, our own comedians, do more of local dialogue comedy more than English, which does not project us to the outside world. You understand?
SDK, you have brought in your family. It's become a family business now. You say your mother and your father are funny. How difficult was it for you to have convinced them to join you in your skits?
Oh, okay. It wasn't that difficult, because it's something that my dad used to do when he was young.
Oh, your dad used to do comedy?
But his dad rather convinced him to...
Your dad convinced you to put him on?
Well, I think way back in, I think, secondary, my dad said, he does this puppet thing, you know,
with the strings and things.
That was what he was doing. And my mom too wanted to join this cantata thing, and he said, like, his dad scared her.
Okay.
So he couldn't join.
So you have opened the door for them.
When I started doing it, I told them. Actually, my mom was my camera woman when I started.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, he started shooting me and stuff. And with my thing, anytime I'm doing something, I love it to be original. I want it to be original. So I didn't want it to put on those wigs, acting as a woman and stuff. So I told my mom, like, okay, act this for me. And they were like, okay, let me do it. We did it the first. People loved it. We did the second time. Well, then my mom was in the house. My dad was rather working. So later on, when my dad retired, he came and he also joined.
So it's become a family business. I think you guys have got a commercial out of that.
Yeah.
Hey, Charlie, business. He's got a deal out of that, just being on the internet. But let's hear something from SDK again, and then we'll be back to wrap up the conversation, because we want to know whether we should stick with the skits. How difficult is the production? How much does it cost them even to put up something?
Bye-bye! Bye! Holla, holla. Ha, bye-bye, bye-bye. Oh my God, oh my God. Let me tell you the truth. I've seen girls and seen girls, I've seen old women and old women, and I've seen grandparents, baby. It's over.
Hey, so you don't remember me?
Well, the girl that told you she had HIV the last time, and I didn't see you again.
It's you. I didn't run. I went to find medicine for you. Because still, I want to eat. Baby, this is shiripate for your HIV. Forget antibiotics. Hey, one spoon, but boom. No, Jinem. So where are you going? You're looking sweet.
I'm off to the supermarket.
Some shopping, eh? That the way. Don't worry, eh? Today I'm on you. You just put some brains. Come and sit inside the car. Let me take you shopping. Let me spend money on you. Hey, to push to Lulu. Ready? In there. Let me spell the book. Be boom, 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 kid. Baby, let's go.
So, Comedian Warris was telling him that FDA should have called him because he was advertising something. Have you had something go really bad where, you know, you've had people call you and say, this thing you put, the content you put out there, is not properly packaged?
Yeah, I think, actually, this one.
Thank
God you didn't finish it. Thank God.
I
think I put a gun on the girl.
Mm.
Yeah, I think this is the second time I did it. The first time, one of the big guys that I respect called me and was like, Charlie, shouldn't be doing that. Shouldn't be pulling guns and stuff. It makes the content sound away, you know, be like some rape culture and stuff.
Mm.
So, and I think the second person would be Lydia Forsen. I went to visit a friend, so they brought a car. I didn't know she was in the car. So I went in, and my friend was trying to introduce
you to her.
So he wasn't remembering. He was like, no, I don't remember. Hey, so it's you that you put a gun on a girl. Eh?
Mm.
Like, yeah, he was like, Charlie, don't do that.
Mm.
I think that it sells a bad image of you. Like, okay. So since then, I stopped, you know, pulling guns, sexualizing women in most of my videos and stuff. The only thing I did that sexualized women was that player skit. I think that was a series.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now you started with your mom being your camera person. Now that your mom and dad are in the production, who gets to film you? How difficult is it to get them to film you? Okay. And do you have a professional setup or you just use a phone?
No, but back then I was using a phone, and with my work, I love to grow. You know, you should see growth in your work. That makes you say, okay, this is where I'm going. Am I dropping back or I'm going forward? So I started using a phone. Then I went to tablets. Then I went to gimbal cameras. Then I went to professional cameras. Mm. Now I don't shoot myself again. I call up a team. I have people that come and do mic for me, lighting. Then I used to edit. Now I don't edit again. I have to, you know, employ someone to do my editing for me.
Then this must really be paying.
Yeah, it pays.
How do you get money from this? Apart from the fact that you are in a commercial, how do you get money from this?
Okay, most of the time when the skit is actually my, you know, when I get the money from the other companies that I get, I save some that I used to shoot my own skits. Mm. But when it's for companies, you know, I have to charge them before I start shooting.
Before you start shooting for them. Warris, you've also been in the news again for a different reason. I want to start it this way. Now you talked about the fact that you wanted to stay a little while in Nigeria and perform more there because they seem to understand and appreciate. Is it also not right for Ghanaians to say...
Ghanaians also appreciate, you understand?
But they do better than we do.
No, what I'm saying is that Ghanaians appreciate. When I went to perform over there, the response I got, it was like, you know, comedy started when it comes to Africa, Nigeria more. Mm. And they see it when you are real and you are good. So they gave me that kind of support.
I'm asking because of the recent conversation around sometimes art kits being taken and repackaged. I'm talking about the case of Ajize and Josh Dufani. Ajize started the Nomfa challenge and all of that.
Yeah.
We didn't see a lot of Ghanaians buy into it. Then the Don't Leave Me challenge comes. I've seen a lot of familiar faces, you know, buying into it. Don't leave me, don't leave me, don't leave me. And he's been complaining all over the place. And I've heard a lot of people also complain about how Ghanaians don't really appreciate what they have until it's foreign.
Well, I think Ghanaians, you see, Ghanaians appreciate us. Ghanaians appreciate Ghanaian comedy. But this is the thing. Our numbers are not enough.
Another bit.
You see, and even that we don't get the projections to read the numbers of Ghanaians who are outside the country. Because we have a lot of Ghanaians who are outside. We have them, and they support even more.
Mm.
They watch the YouTubes, they don't get the TV to watch, they watch online content and all that. You understand? So every time when I talk, I always plead that we will get more projections from our works.
Did you get disappointed when you saw some of the people here in Ghana partaking in that challenge?
Well, I think it's, there are challenges that come. We do challenges and then they do too. Just like if you have been polos, picture she posted yesterday. Mm-hmm. I saw Kem post it and he remade it.
But one thing is that for them, you know, they are big people also support. Mm. And they have a very large influence. I think because if I think someone who is not all that into this comedy thing will see Don Jazzy posting their stuff, will be like, oh, Don Jazzy post, then let me post. But here, maybe if Warris start a challenge, it will stay around we the comedians alone. You understand? Mm. You won't have these big people joining.
Why is it so? Is it that the challenge is not interesting?
I feel like
it's interesting.
Like
you know that they feel
our big people feel big.
Because I've done skit for you know big
to join us do something. Sometimes you do something for real, Charlie. Sometimes this one it really hurts.
Yeah.
You do something and then you do it for somebody, and then it turns out that the person does not even come to like.
Mm.
Doesn't like or anything.
Or even put it on the story for you to even screenshot and say, oh, he appreciated it. You understand? No. All those little things, no? When I started comedy, there was one thing I kept telling all my friends who were around me. I told them that when you start a madness, do that madness till it becomes everybody's madness.
Mm.
Now, AY Poyo's madness is everybody's madness. You understand? In a way, the way he started, he's growing. And he's growing to the extent that the way we pushed him, he's now learning to package. If you push me today and I'm getting there, won't I package myself? Oh, whoa. You understand? But it looks like we have all left ourselves alone. We have, like, when SDK does it and I see it, oh, it a be, but actually I just like come go. Now, in Nigeria, even if Don Jazzy reposts SDK's thing, there is a blogger who come and post that, hey, this boy make camo. That one is another level on a hype. You understand?
And that's what we don't have here.
And it looks like there are people have become selective, the media. And then they have people, they post, they have this one, they post. So, look, this thing causes a lot of depression to some people who are doing legit work. And they feel like, oh, you are not helping me. How will I do to go? Oh, let me insert this one. Oh, let me do this. You understand? Look at somebody like Rhyme Sonny. Great artist. You won't see him on any platform if he doesn't cause any negativity. And he won't. But within, would you ask him that he's okay?
I think that negative vibe, I think the media are so fed into it. Like, that's the main thing now for everyone. Charlie, I should have some negative vibe.
We are all good
me.
Boys, but we are all good. But sometimes you feel like, since you know about the industry, you feel like, oh, maybe if I talk about this one, I'll get the attention. So, since I'm a good boy and I still want the attention, let me go for it.
Anyway, that's all time will allow us. You just heard Comedian Warris and also SDK, both of them comic actors. And they are trying very hard to do a lot of skits in this season so that we can get, you know, entertained. So patronize their works, you know. They are all on social media. Go find out some of the stuff we showed you. Go find out some more from them. They need the support, like you've heard them say. And we hope that we are also able to make ourselves proud beyond the shores. But